I get the feeling that it's, you know, one of those spray and pray tactics. It's one of the things that they said, oh, we should just try this and see if it works because we're dying and, you know, it's not going to work. So that's sort of how I feel about it. And I don't believe in paywall. I mean, it's the simple analogy that I always say in a meeting is, you know, I'm going to go to iTunes and buy a song because I'm going to listen to that song maybe 1,000 times because I really like the music. I'm going to pay 99 cents for an article. I'll read it once and I'll never read it again, ever. I mean, I've consumed that content. It's not going to be something that I'll pay that I'll use again, or as a song I will use again. So that's sort of the challenge that I always come to in my mind is to, if I keep on thinking of that example, the conclusion I come to is paywall is just not going to work. Right now, the New York Times is just using basic ad server technology and AdSense, Google AdSense. They're not using any sort of, you know, they don't have any engineers that they've hired to help them do ad targeting. They don't really invest any time in doing much ad targeting. It's sort of like, oh, well, what we get is what we get. And we're going to use Google Ad Manager, and that's going to be the extent of our targeting. No, that's not going to work. Local businesses are the laggards in the whole thing, but the larger businesses and brands, which are what New York Times usually sells ads to, or at like Home Depot, et cetera, those companies are pretty well acclimated with it, or they have an agency that is pretty well acclimated with it.
Right.
So they're actually progressing faster than the papers or the media companies.
I can believe that.
And the reason for that is because a lot of those companies are performance-based. So United Airlines needs to sell X number of tickets. So what are they going to do? Invest in some targeting technology that makes sure that their conversion rate to buying a ticket from a media buy is going to lead to X number of tickets. So they really have a very metrics and math-driven problem to solve. So it's sort of, oh, okay, well, if that's the problem, then that means I just need to invest more money in the targeting, not in the actual, not in any sort of content creation or anything like that, which is sort of what the Times is sort of, you know, weighing, is that do we do ad targeting, do we improve our content, or we don't really know where we're going, whereas it's just a simple math problem for a lot of these businesses that are trying to sell goods. Be ready to be on your own as a journalist, as, you know, that you're going to be creating content on your own. And don't be afraid of being on your own, because on your own might be better than working for one of these large media organizations. You know, these large media organizations are slow. They don't really, you won't learn very much. You'll be forced to write on topics that you might not want to write on. And, you know, that you should have a lot more freedom as to the kind of content that you want to create. I mean, you're going to school to learn how to write well, and that you should apply that craft to the things that are interesting to you. So I would say invest the time on your own to figure out what it means to go it alone, and figure out the tools that you would need to use in order to start generating your own revenue and your own readership and your own users directly. And that's going to make you, you know, a very, very valuable, very, very valuable commodity. I mean, don't forget that a lot of these big blogs that are out there now, like Politico and Huffington Post and you know, Raw Story in Miami and all these, even TechCrunch, which is a big tech blog in California, they were all started by one guy in a room who started blogging to get readers very early on, and it sort of ballooned out, and then it became a big company. So, I mean, if you start garnering users or readers right now, and you start focusing on that in college while you're, you know, you're able to sort of be sort of free because you're in college,